Hope you all are doing well. Today's vlog is about a river which is very close to my home, that is Naranipura. I had traveled through this area many times but never got a chance to explore this amazing place through a boat ride. So when I went up for my last vlog, I came across this area and decided to cover this beauty in my next vlog. This Naranipura bridge is located in Malappuram district between my village Eramangalam and Changarangulam. Actually, these two villages were not connected and people used small boats to travel between these two places. About 37 years back, this bridge was built and got connected. Naranipura or Narani River. What I heard is this name got derived from the Malayalam usage Narinindipura. Before coming here, I had asked my father and uncles who knows very well about this place and surroundings and collected all details. That's a small island surrounded by this river and that was given by a landlord to their workers long time back. There are almost 22 families of their generation still staying in that area. Earlier, it was an isolated island and people used small boats to travel in between, but now you can see there is a way. That's my brother, and after coming home, he is there with me for coordinating all my videos and he has arranged this boat ride. He is like my childhood friend. Here you go, we are heading to the river. This is the way to the shore of Naranipura where we have arranged the boat. On the way, Appu and Tanu got some new friends. They were scared a bit in the beginning but came close to them soon. This is a boat in which we are going to ride through this river. When I told boat ride, did you expect a big one? Meet our captain, Mr. Mohammed Ali, and he's gonna take us today to show the innermost beauty of this river and its surroundings. So excited. So everything ready, we are all set to go on board. Monsoon has just started, hence the water level is not that much in the river. Still, we had arranged safety jackets for the kids. Except Appu, all of us know swimming, but we didn't want to take a risk. Almost 3 years back, a tragic event happened at this place, somewhere closer. On a Christmas vacation time, 8 children took a similar boat and went for a ride. But unfortunately, the boat got overturned and 6 of them lost their life. Only 2 got rescued. So I would like to tell something related with this matter. It's easy to train swimming to kids and it will take only 2 weeks and there are several training centers for that. I'm glad to see Tanu taking care of Appu with full rights of an elder sister. And it took me back to my childhood days when my sister cared for me and still she does the same. Appu is the one who is most curious in this trip. This is the first time in his life and he has all that passion. He used to trouble my hubby with lots of questions on different matters and today it got doubled. His main concern was whether there are crocodiles in this river. To keep him control, both my hubby and brother told yes, so that he won't touch the water. I wish I could capture each and every sport in this place, but time and memory in my camera won't allow that. Here is the real fun of having a riverside home. Look at the kids are having a good time by swimming in clean and crystal clear water. There he is. My Mamudka asked kids it's deep or not. Appu was asking whether there are crocodiles or not, and his doubt continues. As I mentioned in my last vlog, I have become a fan of these birds. How many varieties are here? I used to know only the white color cranes, but after I started exploring, I could see different species of these cranes. Thank you. As I mentioned earlier, this is the beginning of monsoon season. Once it gets strengthened, the water will rise above the area where the people are standing, and now it's not that deep. We are getting closer to Narnipura Bridge, from where we have started this travel. This name Narnipura was not that famous earlier, but now most of the Keralais must have heard about this name. It's not about this river, but through the name of a movie director. Script and direction of the latest Malayalam movie Soofiyum Sujathayum was done by Mr. Narnipura Shanavas. He's from this locality and kept name of this beautiful river with his name. No wonder beauty of this river and the location is really influencing, especially for an artist like him. Finally, we have reached Narnipura Bridge. I have started my video somewhere from that point. Now covering this much distance through the river, we came near to this. Now we'll pass under this bridge. What a stunning view of this river. Beautiful lush green waterfront with quiet peaceful sounds of the boat passing through this river. We are turning the boat around and going back to the place from where we have started. Covered almost 3 kilometers through Narnipura. When the guys got a chance, you know they couldn't control, just jumped in. Kids also, I couldn't stop them because this experience is very rare for them. This area is safe, so I thought let them enjoy without thinking much. On the way back, each of us tried to row the boat. I am not sure about the correct word for this method. Even Appu also tried. You won't believe, it's not easy like we think. It's too difficult to lift the stick from the water and row it. And I was thinking how he managed to cover this much distance without taking a break. Hats off. When all of them played in water, I also wanted to join but was not comfortable to do it there. So when I got a safe place, I didn't have a second thought, just dropped myself in water. The question is, why is this fencing here? Actually, I also have the same doubt. This is made for catching fish by the local people with bamboo and supari tree. See, a crazy man is enjoying to the fullest and having fun like kids. By watching this grass, you might be thinking how come a river looks like this. Actually, this is a joining area between the farms and river. In summer, all this area will be dry. In fact, Narnipura is not a river, it's a long lake. A water reservoir for the paddy field starting from Palani area in Thrissur till the farms in Ayilakkad, Ponnani. This river is connected with BM Kayal in Ponnani, a backwater close to this place. Other than that, it doesn't have any connection to the sea or any other major river like the big ones. Still, it's called as Narani River. We are heading back to the starting point. When the kids saw this, they wanted to go back to water again. By listening to this, Mohammadka took us to an awesome place, clean water, clean and firm bed and no deep at all. What else we need to let the kids go? Not only the kids, look at that big man. Going to be a lovely sunset, birds heading to their home. We also should go, but what to say, not feeling to go back, just wanted to stay in this water for a long time. I know all of us are going through tough time in their life. We have been through more difficult times and we shall overcome this too. So stay safe, stay happy. Bye-bye.